Please stand as you're able. You may be seated. Friends, we've gathered here to witness and to bless the joining together in a Christian marriage of Josh and Lindsay. The covenant of marriage was established by God who created us for each other. With his presence and power, Jesus graced a wedding at Cana of Galilee, and in his sacrificial love gave us the example of marriage love. And in the relationship of the Trinity, we see an example and a symbol of how God created us in God's image. Lindsay and Josh come to give themselves to one another in this holy covenant with each other and with God. And so I'll ask you both now in the presence of God and all these people to declare your intention to live together in holy union through the grace of Jesus Christ, who calls us into union with himself through our baptism. So I ask you each, Lindsay, will you have Josh to be your husband to live together in holy marriage? Will you love him, comfort her, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health? And forsaking all others, will you be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
And Josh, will you have Lindsay to be your wife to live together in holy marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Now the marriage of Lindsay and Josh unites their families and creates a new one. They ask your blessing. So you who represent their families, do you rejoice in their union and pray God's blessing upon them? So say we do. Beautiful. And all of us, they've invited us here not just to see an event, but to be participants in their lives. You've been a meaningful part of their lives up to this point, and they are challenging and inviting you to be a meaningful part of their lives moving forward. So will you do everything in your power by God's grace to uphold and care for Lindsay and Josh in their marriage? If so, say, we will.
We will.
Wonderful. Let us pray. God of all peoples, you are the true light illumining everyone, and you show us the way, the truth, and the life. You love us even when we are unlovely. You sustain us with your Holy Spirit. We praise you for your presence with us, and especially in this act of solemn covenant. Send your Spirit upon us that we might see in this covenant-making celebration your life in the midst of our lives. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts and the covenant acts we witness today lead us deeper into your presence through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As you're able, let's stand for the reading of the gospel from John. And this is the passage that Lindsay and Josh picked for us to hear today. It's in John 15. Jesus is speaking to his disciples and he says, "As the Father has loved me, I too have loved you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and your joy will be complete. this is my commandment. Love each other just as I have loved you. No one has greater love than to give up one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I don't call you servants any longer because servants don't know what their master is doing. Instead, I call you friends because everything I heard from my Father I have made known to you. You didn't choose me, but I chose you and appointed you so that you could go and produce fruit and so that your fruit could last. As a result, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give to you. I give you these commandments so that you can love each other. Here ends the reading. You may be seated. Now, it's sometimes a joke, but I do wonder, honestly, once in a while, if for some of us, it's true, as they say, that opposites attract. Have you ever wondered that? I had a small experience of that in this last week. Did you go to the concert, by the way, for the county fair this week? Some of you, I assume, did go to the concert. We live right next door, so we could hear the concert from our backyard. We went for a walk that night, and we were walking. I could hear little snippets of every song, and I could sing the words of each of the songs. And my wife looked at me like I was from another planet. I don't know. Apparently, I grew up listening to country music, and she from the city was listening to something completely different. It was like we were just created in different worlds. And so that's your first homework tonight. If you sit down with someone and you don't know them, you can ask them at the reception, what type of music did you listen to as a teen? It will at least garner some good laughs. And you could follow that up with, what were your favorite dance moves? Josh, any examples? All right. So, speaking of music, though, that inspires us, I'm a big musical fan, and so there's a 1985 musical called Big River. It's the story of Huckleberry Finn that is written by Mark Twain. And in it, there's a song called Worlds Apart. Kind of two worlds being combined. Now, I hear this song, and each of the characters, Huck Finn, who's a boy, runaway, and runaway slave named Jim, they each sing versions of these lyrics. I see the same stars through my window that you see through yours. I see the same skies through brown eyes that you see through blue. I see the same, just like the earth, just like the sun, two worlds together are better than one. I see the sunrise in your eyes that you see in mine. But we're worlds apart, worlds apart. Now, this song marks a turning point in the musical. They recognize that though they are considerably different, that they see each other and their true humanity, they see their friendship, and they see that they are better together. Even though in some ways it does feel and is that they are from two different worlds. So maybe there's hope for us if we're feeling like we're opposites once in a while. But it's your stories that reminded me of this musical. Because one of the stories is your second date. I don't know if they've told you, and I'll tell it differently than they will. But Josh and Lindsay, they met here at church, and then they went out to dinner here in town and enjoyed a nice dinner and some good conversation. But on their second date, they decided to take that show on the road and go to dinner elsewhere, right? You still remember this? And it was like Josh was, at this point, testing Lindsay. I really think this is how this was. Like, well, the gloves are going to come off. She's going to see the real full me, and that's the really full me. And that's just how it's going to be, and it's going to work. They went to Elwood for prime rib and crab legs, and there was no dainty dining for this guy. All right? Because if you know Josh, he said, well, if you know me, you know that I like to eat. And you even had a blizzard on the way home. And for a while, I read my notes, and I thought, that's weird. I don't remember that we had a blizzard about that time of year. But then I realized it was just ice cream. So apparently, When we stand next to you, Josh, we're all sort of worlds apart when it comes to your abilities. The other way that I thought about this song was, Lindsay, you told me recently about something that you do with the girls and together, that you talk about sunrises or sunsets. So you look out over the west from your house and you see these sunsets. And it's like Tom and Huck and Jim. We see the sunrise in each other's eyes. We see the sunset in each other's eyes. We see life and experience through those that we're in relationship with. And so no matter whether it feels like your world's apart, you're living in different places or households, when you go off to vacation in different places, when you go off to college or somewhere else, you can still look to the west and see those sunrises and see that your worlds, though you're different, are better together. And so that's something that I think is also happening in this gospel passage. And there's a lot of things that are happening. This is part of what John's Last Supper sequence is. And so Jesus knows it and has told them that he'll be betrayed and then crucified, and then he will die and then be raised. But in the midst of this, he's giving them instructions. And it's almost like he's saying to them that you've seen me, we've seen each other, and now when we are going to literally be worlds apart, this is what you should do. Now, I asked Josh and Lindsay if why they chose this passage, and it wouldn't be nice if I asked you to tell them all now, but they said all the right answers. They picked up all the main themes of this passage about how Jesus is calling people to love and faithfulness, how he's calling them to show God's love to each other, and in doing so, it's showing God's love to the world. And it talked about this commitment and this obedience of following Jesus. These are the themes that you picked up and talked about and why you chose this passage. But I think it's really significant that it's something that we're seeing in action today, together, through you. See, Jesus is talking to his disciples, but I think it's really about all of our relationships. His message extends to all of the ways that we're in relationships with others, romantic and otherwise. And especially yours. See, when we see love, when we get to be in this congregation and look up at you, when we see the love of family and friends, when we see great relationships, when we see people nurturing one another toward their best selves, when we see people picking each other up when we fall and stumble, we see something of who God is. See, already, Josh and Lindsay, you've declared your intention to love, comfort, honor, protect each other in sickness and health for the rest of your lives. This is how we started. And in a moment, you'll make vows to each other to live with love and to cherish each other as partners from this day forward, for better, for worse, for sick and sickness and health, for richer, for poorer. That's a beautiful thing. See, these actions and these words, they're the most important for you today. And we all recognize that. But I want you to know that you've blessed us, all of us, by inviting us to see you say those things. Because it reminds us of when we've said those things. And it reminds us of what love can be in our lives. See, God is revealing God's self through your covenant acts today. And God is revealing God's self each and every day when you should put on love for one another. So here's my charge for you both and for all of us. Let the love and the covenant that we see today inspire us. Inspire us to pour ourselves out fully in the relationships of love that we have, whether it's friends or family or partners. And then let us take up Jesus' charge to love others as our daily calling. We wake up and we know we have a to-do list that keeps on going, right? And we go to bed with that list still compiling. But what if we made sure to remember that our first to-do is just to be a people of love who reveal God's love for others? And then let us find ways to love like Jesus, to lift each other up when we're down, to seek the best in one another, to work for their good, even if it costs us a little bit of time or energy. And then let us see sunrises and let us see sunsets in each other's eyes. so that we can see that God has called us together in friendships and relationships and partnerships and marriages, so that we can reveal God for one another. And then may we see that whenever we love one another, we draw together two worlds into one. That we're no longer worlds apart, but that we are indeed better together, and that we reveal God for one another. May it be so. Amen. So we'll have that part that we were just talking about with the vows. But we'll pray for you, because these are big things. Let's pray. Eternal God, creator and preserver of all life, author of salvation and giver of grace, bless and make holy, but with your Holy Spirit, Josh and Lindsay and their marriage and their family. Grant that they may give their vows to each other in the strength of your steadfast love. Bless them as they exchange rings as signs of their vows, symbols of their unending union. Enable them to grow in love and peace with you and with one another all their days, that they may reach out in concern and service to the world through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So now is the time that you get to make these vows to one another. And I'll step aside because pictures are better that way. But don't forget just to look at her, not me. In the name of God, I, Josh.
In the name of God, I, Josh.
Take you, Lindsay, to be my wife.
Take you, Lindsay, to be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
Sickness and health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we're parted by death.
Until we're parted by death.
Amen. Lindsay, I give you this ring.
Lindsay, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. And Lindsay, in the name of God, I, Lindsay.
In the name of God, I, Lindsay.
Take you, Josh.
Take you, Josh.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
Have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
Josh, I give you this ring.
Josh, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Your turn. Kaylee and Allie, as I promise my love, support, and loyalty to your dad, I also make promises to you. I promise that I'll always be here for you, to cry with you, and to laugh with you. I promise to keep being goofy or weird, as long as it means making you smile. I promise to dream with you, pray with you, and always encourage you. I promise to always make you use your manners, because I know you'll be a better person for it. I promise to sing and dance with you and keep sharing our love for music. I promise to always point out the sunset, because it's something we can always share, even when we are apart. But most importantly, I promise to listen to you, I promise to care for you, and I promise to love you and your dad all my life. Now I'm shaking. This one's yours.
Now, if you three stay up there, and Josh, you join them. Josh, Lindsay, Kaylee, and Atlee will place a rock in a jar representing who they are as individuals, each with their unique personalities and strengths, and then they will pour the sand and blend in their four colors, representing their commitment to each other. And as the individual grains of sand can no longer be separated, may their bond be inseparable. As they do this, and as music plays, let's pray for them. Whatever way that you want to send them positive vibes, pray God's blessing, do so now. Beautiful things. Let's pray for this couple and for their family. Oh God, you've so consecrated the covenant of Christian marriage that in it is represented the covenant between Christ and his church. Send therefore your blessing upon Lindsay and Josh that they may surely keep their marriage covenant and so grow in love and godliness, and that their home may be a haven of blessing and peace. Most gracious God, we give you thanks for your tender love in making us a covenant people through our Savior Jesus Christ and for consecrating in his name the marriage covenant of Lindsay and Josh. Grant that their love for each other may reflect the love of Christ for us and grow from strength to strength as they faithfully serve you in the world. Defend them from every enemy, lead them into all peace, and let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts and a mantle about their shoulders and a crown upon their heads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, in their sleeping and in their waking, in their joys and in their sorrows, in their lives and in their deaths. And finally, by your grace, bring them and all of us to that table where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. In all of this, we give you thanks and praise, Almighty God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, forever and ever. Amen. So now that Lindsay and Josh have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, that with the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings, I, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, I announce to you that they are husband and wife. Now, may Lindsay and Josh, may God confirm that. May you leave this place knowing that your worlds are making each other better each and every day. And then may you all, may we all who have seen something of God in them and together, may we go charged and challenged and empowered to bear God's love for one another, being witnesses of God. May you go in peace. The kiss of peace be with you. It's my joy and privilege to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Cook.